Hey guys, this is Nefarious411 and welcome to episode 107 of Regrowth. I am sitting here trying to make a potion because I am going to continue on, even though I cheated, basically reverted the one that I chose. I'm going to go with the Infernal Animus to do the binding because you can only choose one of these. And I thought this would be kind of cool because you can basically make animals to do things for you. You can even gain their abilities, which I'm kind of interested in seeing what that means. But I just finished creating the Potion of Harming, and that is going to be needed for my cauldron over here, or my kettle, I can't remember which one. But I think I might have everything for the Infernal Animus. So let me look in here. This is going to take the demon heart, if you remember from last episode. We ended up having to summon the demon to get his heart. But then we have the Potion of Harming, which is what I have right here. Instant damage 2. I have Redstone Soup, Refined Evil, and Blaze Rod. And right here, I created a Voodoo Poppet. So I figure might as well go ahead and get all of this stuff prepared. So if I look here, we have all six things. And let me just double check. This is the kettle. All right. So let me go ahead and grab a bucket of water. There we go. And let's go ahead and throw this stuff in and see what we can come up with. Oh, yeah. Let me go ahead and get a couple of bottles. Hopefully, well, I guess this would only really need one, right? But it gave me two. That's fine. I got two Infernal Animus. I'll probably, I don't know what I'm going to do with that one. All right, so here we go. We got it. And that completed that side. I can throw those away since I've already claimed them. Even though it's really not that big of a deal since I have tons of these witch's hands and regeneration potions. But let me go ahead and do the next one, which should be killing the Ent, and I did that already. But I haven't created the Mystic Unguent yet. So let's take a look at the Unguent. Unguent. There we go. This one doesn't look too bad. Potion of Strength. Probably need to create that diamond. Ooh, Demonic Blood. So that's Diamond Vapor and a Demon Heart. So let's go ahead and get that guy going. Because I have a couple of hearts here. Diamond Vapor. Looks like I'm going to have to restock on Diamond Vapor. Diamond Vapor. Demon Heart. There we go. Let's go ahead and keep our inventory somewhat clean while we're working, because I don't know what this is going to do. Let me just put that Infernal Animus back in there for now. And we'll come back for it later, but that's going to get the Demon Blood. Let's see, I have a Creeper Heart right there, so let's go ahead and keep all of our items. Oh, that's interesting. Gunpowder. Let me just keep the items there for now. Don't want to accidentally create the powder there. Diamond. That one's pretty simple. Unguent. Let's see, a Rowan Sapling. Guess it's really only... Did I run out of Redstone Soup? No. Whew. I still have some Redstone Soup. Alright, cool. So that goes there. Just trying to keep things kind of straightened in my head. So let's go ahead and... Ooh, I got Refined Evil from that too. That's kind of nice. There we go. And Rowan Sapling. Rowan Sapling. And I'll need to run to the other building. See if I have any Potion of Strength. See, do I have any Potion of Strength? Potion of Harming, Fire Resistance, Invincibility. Potion of Healing. Potion of Strength 2? Oh wait, that's a Splash Potion. Ugh! Healing, healing. Yeah, most of mine are like healing. Strength. Ooh, here we go. Potion of Strength 2. Nice! I think this is the one that I need. Let me just double check. Unguent. 8 minute. Ooh. I think I can get to the 8 minute just by throwing redstone. Why is that 3 minutes? This is not the same thing. Let me go ahead and try doing redstone. I don't think this will work. I mean, will this make it go 8 minutes? I don't know. This might actually make it into something else. I don't know. Usage. Doesn't look like there's any uses on it, but it's doing something. Let's see. Oh, there we go. Nice. Hopefully this one actually works. It had weird metadata on that one. All right, so we have all of the ingredients that are needed. So let me go ahead and put those here. And let's go ahead and fill the kettle. Let me just double check that this is kettle. Ungent. Yep, this is a kettle. So let's go ahead and throw these in. Nice. All right, so let's get some empty bottles. Hopefully we can get more than one, but it only looks like one, of course. All right, cool. So that finished that one. So now we need a mystic branch. All right. So a mystic branch, it says that finally prepare a small and medium circle of white ritual chalk and drop the twig and unguent into the circle. As long as there are 3,000 power nearby, you can activate the rite, applying the unguent to the twig, creating a mystic branch. This ritual can only be performed at night. So I think small and medium circles, I got those. So that and a int twig, I got plenty of those. And it's nighttime, so this might actually work. Let me get my bucket out of my hand. You and you. No. Those are white circles. Did I read that wrong? Let's see. As long as there are 3,000 power nearby, I do. Applying the unguent to the twig, creating. Okay. Small and medium circle of the white ritual chalk. I did. That is confusing. Let me try this again. Oh, wait. It's doing it now. Just didn't want to before. All right, cool. So we have a mystic branch. Cool. And cool. Now I can claim the reward, potion of regen, which we really don't need, but that did complete that particular quest line. Nice. And that unlocked two quests elsewhere. I'm not entirely sure where. I'm kind of curious. Oh. Okay. Apparently it unlocked this one, and I had already completed it, so that is good. And maybe under 12? No. 15? No, I still need to get back to that one. I don't think it actually opened up two. I think it only opened up one. All right, so let me go ahead and clean up my inventory. Probably sleep through the night, and I'll be right back. All right, I am back. And one thing that I realized is we never actually bound the Infernal Animus to our player. And I am going to do that. And I think all I have to do is put this into a circle with me. I created the small and the medium circles, the 7x7 and 11x11, using the purple. Unfortunately, it does say that the spirit of otherware. So I don't know if this is going to cause a problem because of the fact that I created the other one first. So even though I reset my quest book, it might not actually work. But it does look like I just need to stand in the circle. Unknown right. I don't think this is gonna work because of the fact that we created the other one first. Well, that kind of stinks. You must stand in the circle. Alter power 4,000, and I'm pretty sure that we're there. No. Let me just double check. Is there another page? Oh, Infernal Animus. I need red, not purple. Well, crap. All right, well, we got the red chalk here, so let's go ahead and convert all of these back to, not back to red, since it was white before, but I wasted a lot of purple chalk to do this. But let me go ahead and do this. And just like that. All right, cool. So I might be able to do it now. No, I'm blind. All right, I got a little bar to there now. Is that going to be there forever now? How do I use this now? I am not sure. I don't know anything about the rite of infusion. Perform at night, imbue a mystic branch. Yeah, I have no idea. I already did that one. Okay, well, we bound it to ourselves. Do I just stare at animals? Let me go over here and stare at a cow. Cow. Do my bidding. Go over there and kill that cow. Do it. I don't know what I'm doing. Well, I got some blue moho pollen. That's kind of interesting. Do I talk to them? Nope. Don't talk to them. Why is there a crafting table here? I don't remember putting a crafting table here. I don't know. I really don't understand how to use this now. That is kind of weird. And I know that the mystic branch that we created... Let me put this chalk away real quick before I misplace it. I know that we should be able to, just like in Harry Potter, be able to draw symbols and do things with them. Whoa! So over to left one, it throws a snowball. The bad thing about it is that you have to be pretty precise on how you draw these. If you go a little bit too far, it's not gonna work out too well. It's Wingardium Leviosa. Oops, that didn't work. See, that's the problem. And if you have to aim it at something, you're kind of screwed if you are facing away too far. Oops. Oh, that did it too. So can I just do that? Oh. That seems to be a little bit easier than I thought. I'm just moving my mouse back and forth and it seems to be working. I think it's not intended that way. Impedimenta. Is this impedimenta too? No, that's flippendo. Expelliarmus. I know that one. Expelliarmus! Hey, it did remove his bow. That is cool. Protego. I don't know what I'm doing. Hey, that one actually worked. Whoa, that actually broke a block. How did I do that? It was up. Was it a circle? Yes, it was. That broke a block. That is cool. That is so much worse than mining. Because it takes forever to do this. I would never do this in a real world situation. I'm not sure if this is going to help us any. I still would like to figure out what the bar... Oh, the bar is drained a little bit. Hey, you. Go talk to him. Oh, wait, that was my blink. I was like, it did something. No, I forgot I had blink on. All right. Well, I probably need to do a little bit of research on that because I have no idea what I'm doing with it. I mean, now I have a bar on the left side of my screen, and I'm not sure what to do with it, and that is not for witchery. So let's take a look in our book real quick. I think we are almost complete. I don't know what to do about the hunted because of the fact that we don't have any kind of real voodoo. I could probably create a couple more of the voodoo puppets, probably bind them or something, but I don't know. We're gonna have to figure out how to get that witch hunter after me. But let's go ahead and do the Brew of Flowing Spirit to go ahead and complete this. Brew of Flowing Spirit. And this one seems to be pretty simple. Wispy cotton in a spinning wheel with odor of purity and string. Odor of purity and string. I'm hoping that I have wispy cotton, and I do, because I don't want to go to the other world, or whatever it's called. What was that? Odor of purity and a string. Do I have any string in here? Might have some in the spinning wheel. I do. All right, so how many wispy cotton did I need? 4. Hey, I got 4. Does it just go, or does it actually need this other stuff? Looks like it might need this other stuff. There it goes. Cool. All right, so that's the first step, and that is pretty cool animation for a block. That was the first step. We need Spanish moss, glint weed, wool of bat. Oh, wool of bat. The bane of my existence. Because I don't think I have any wool of bat. Oh, I got one. Saved. All right. Nice. Let's go ahead and grab a glint weed and one of these water artichokes. And a mandrake root, another Harry Potter reference. And that got the 4. All right. Spanish moss, I got that. And I need the string that's over here, and that should do it for this. Nice. All right, so I think I put my bucket away, so let's go ahead and grab that bucket of water again. There we go. Throw this into the kettle. All 6 items. Bam, bam, bam. And I need some of these empty glass bottles. And it only gave me 1. Water bottle. Wait. Did I do that completely wrong? What was I supposed to get? Brew of Flowing Spirit. Brew of Glowing Spirit. Flowing Spirit, not glowing. Yeah, this was a kettle. I don't know what happened. It didn't do it. I guess it's because I'm not wearing witch's robes? I am not sure. Alright, looks like I'm gonna have to go kill some bats because I have run out of wool of bat. Alright, so let me go ahead and do that. Let me see if I can get that potion again, and I will be right back. Alright, I am back, and no success. I did some looking, and it appears that the flowing spirit, brew of flowing spirit, can only be done in the spirit world, and I really don't want to essentially start from scratch. And I think that's essentially what you have to do, because if you remember, whenever we go to the overworld, or the, what's that called? The spirit world, we start with nothing. We have nothing in our inventory, and we basically have to start from scratch, and I am not going to do that. So I'm not going to do this one. So there are apparently a couple of things that I am not going to do in Chapter 10. And I think those are the only ones that are needed. But I am not too worried about going into the spirit world. So even though that says that it unlocks 2 quests elsewhere, those are just going to be not done. I mean, I guess the only thing that we could do is if I were to do an HQM edit. And we get this guy and we complete that. I think that's the only thing that we really can do at this point. if we wanted to get 100% completion. So let me go ahead and throw that back in. There we go. And let's go ahead and claim the reward. I'm not very happy about it, but that's the problem with the spirit world. You end up having to redo everything from scratch, and I am not going to do that. I'm not going to even use those. I just went ahead and claimed it. Have witch's robes and hat, so I am just going to put those in there. Alright, so back to what I was wanting to do. I don't know if this unlocked anything. Doesn't look like it. Looks like we're in chapter 12 now, so let me take a look at the spectral familiar. So it does look like we need to look in our circle magic at page 56. 56 is right here, rite of summoning. Summoning a familiar to find things. Try giving the familiar a diamond. The inner area must be clear, 7x7x4 blocks. Drop of luck, raw pork chop, gold ingot, Arthana. Okay. You remember a way to spawn a familiar which can find things for you. While it was useful in the past for helping you find some rare ores. Okay, so I guess I'm going to do this one. Alright, so let's take a look at the Circle Magic book again. Drop of luck, raw pork chop. So let me go ahead and grab a pork chop. I don't know where that came from. Raw pork chop. And what was the other stuff? Drop of luck. Drop of luck. Doesn't look like I have drop of luck. What does that consist of? Drop of luck. That doesn't look too bad. I think I can do that one right now. So let's go ahead and throw this in here. And let's go ahead and grab our mandrake root. Let me just put them all right here. Mandrake root. Another wart. I think these might have to go in a particular order. I am just going to do it in the same order they have it here. Tear of the Goddess, Refined Evil. Whoa, that was weird. Tear of the Goddess, I got one of those. Refined Evil. Is this it? Okay. So let's go ahead and run over here. Might as well put these robes back on. I don't think they're going to help us much. But I should be able to come across here. Throw all of that stuff in. And it will produce something for us. Eventually. I hope. There we go. Cool. Drop of luck. Nice. All right. So I was creating that because in order to do this, I need drop of luck. All right. Drop of luck. Raw pork chop. And gold ingot and Arthana. All right. So let's go ahead and grab that Arthana. These are pretty simple to make. And ingot. Well, might as well just type gold. I guess that's it. Let me just double check. Cool. And what kind of circles does this take? I think that's white. So it looks like I'm going to have to draw white circle again. So I'm going to get rid of this inner red circle. Pretty simple. All you have to do is place it on top of the other and it goes away just like so. Cool. And I am going to throw all of those down. Right click. There is my spectral familiar. Can I trade with it? Oh, haha! That is cool. He's tamed. Alright, you sit there for a second. I need to get away from those frogs. Kind of sad that I have to kill them. I don't want to kill them. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. And I'm using the Arthana I used to summon him with. Oh, I'm sorry. All right. But it did give me that, and I can claim the reward. That is nice. All right, so let me go ahead and clean up my inventory, check the time on the video, and see where we are, and I will be right back. All right, looks like we have about 5 minutes left. So looking in here, I saw this, and this is pretty simple, I think. So let me go ahead and see glass goblet. I'm assuming it's just glass. Yeah, it is. So let's go ahead and create one of those, and we can just go ahead and throw a couple of these off the thing. Glass goblet. There we go. Done. Killing task. Sacrificial chicken. Why does it want me to kill so many things? The book, the old dark desires. Using the bolon. Sacrifice a chicken. What bolon? Have I created one of those? Over the skull by the light of the moon. Over what skull? Bolin. Okay. I'll go ahead and create one of these. Get rid of that. I guess I didn't need that. Spectral. Let me keep the witchery stuff out here. Well, it's not nighttime, so it looks like we're going to have to at least wait until night before we can actually do this. Got an extra Arthana now. And a skull. It said the skull, right? Over the skull. Doesn't say which skull. I guess skeleton skull. Because that was earlier in the quest. Skeleton skull. Looks like four of these. Creates a skeleton skull. Okay, let's go ahead and put my armor back on. There we go. Cool. You can go away. Skeleton skull. And looks like I'm going to need a chicken. I don't know if I have any chicken. Chicken. No, I don't. And Chuck the chicken apparently passed away at some point. Chuck the chicken's gone. It's kind of sad. Not sure what happened to him. But he disappeared one day. Let me see if I can create some eggs, maybe. Let me, if this is going to require a full-grown chicken, I need to do this soon. What am I looking for? Not that. Let me grab some andesite. Let me make a little coop here. Just like so. So that the chicken can't go away. Let's go ahead and start throwing eggs in here. Hopefully a chicken will spawn, and there's one. Well, apparently that did work, but the egg went through the andesite. All right, looks like I'm going to have to wait for these chickens to mature. And I'm assuming that I just need to kill a chicken with a bolon under the light of the moon. Whew, this is getting dark. All right. Sorry, guy, but you're the chosen one. We'll see you soon. All right. Well, I was taking a look through the quest book and trying to figure out how this is going to work. And I did see that I didn't read this other stuff. And I think it's because these were completed before, since of the fact that, I mean, we have redstone and string. So laying out the site requires some specific components listed below. A diagram of the ritual site can be found in Observations of an Immortal. Fortunately, I already had another star in there because I killed the wither several times. But we should take a look at this. Does it say which? No, it doesn't say which page. Well, there we go. Looks like we need to do this at night. Open moon, string, red dust, torches, and skull. I can't really tell how far that is. butchering a chicken. I don't know. Is this like right next to it? I mean, it's nighttime now, but my chickens haven't matured yet. I created a little platform up here so that the other chicken was able to go in, and he did. So that was unfortunate for him. But I am not sure from this diagram how that's supposed to go. I think it's the same level. But if I do that, the chickens will run away. Let me try doing it from in here. I really don't want these chickens to run away. Redstone. Let me go ahead and place this in a circle around this, just like so. All right. I think that's supposed to symbolize blood. Taking a look in here again. It looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but is a string coming this way around the torch? This is confusing. So I think I have to skip string. Here we go. Let me get rid of that. So if I skip one and put the string here, 5, 1, let me just double check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Kind of looks that way. But then we have to come in around a torch. Torch. There we go. Torch. Two, three, four, five. Torch here. And that. Alright, I think this is it. Minus all of the andesite here. Let me go ahead and get rid of all of the extra andesite that I don't need anymore. Oop, I need that. I need that. Chickens are gonna escape. There we go. This is weird. I don't know if this is going to work. They're not even full grown yet. Don't think I need this level. I don't think they can get out of that. Hello, chickens? Nope. They're still not fully mature yet. But that looks correct. I mean, as far as this drawing is telling me. Oops, that's the wrong book. And I think that it has to be a mature chicken. I can find that out here in a second. Since there's two chickens in here. No! Get back in there! Okay, that didn't work out too well. Well, you. That didn't work. Let me try a lead. Let me go ahead and clear all of this stuff off. I'm not sure how they expect anybody to get a chicken to actually do this. But if I use a lead, and obviously I can't use the lead unless it's a mature chicken. Am I supposed to put the goblet anywhere? Let me just double check here. Once the site is prepared, you must prepare yourself to perform sacrifice by moonlight. To perform the sacrifice, you need to be able to collect blood from a chicken. A goblet of glass is the apparently the appropriate vessel. Okay. All right. Well, where'd that chicken go? Chicky. Chick, 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 chick. I heard him. Oh, he's right there. I don't think I can. Yeah. Oh, wait, I can. You stay here. And I am going to sacrifice you as soon as you're an adult. Alright, so let me wait for him to be an adult. Does look like I'm going to have to wait at least another night-day cycle. And you, I'm sorry to say, but you're going to die like your friend there. So let me do that and I'll be right back. All right, it is nighttime and my chicken is fully matured. So now it's just a matter of getting him on top of that skull, right? That's going to be a trick. Come here, come here. I got a little bit to go. Ooh, come on. All right, I think this is it. I don't know if it has to be midnight. Hey, where'd you go? I don't know if it has to be midnight, but the moon is about to crest the apartment building. And I'm gonna... Ugh, lag spike. That was not good. All right, you get on there. Kill you! It didn't fill my cup. It didn't fill my cup. Do I have another chicken? Where's that lead? Lead. Where did that lead go? Lead. Got more chickens in here because I thought this would happen. Not sure where my lead went. Let me go ahead and create another one. Any mature yet? Oh, come on. Somebody's got to be mature. All right. I'm going to try a baby chicken. I don't know if it has to be a full moon or not. Come here. I know this isn't going to be pleasant. I killed him with the bowline. What am I missing? Are all the strings here? It's really hard to tell. Looks like all the strings are here. Wait, what's that? Oh, I had an extra string there. I don't know if that caused any problems. Let me grab the lead. Another baby chicken. Sorry. Apparently one of my chickens died or... I don't know. I don't think this is going to work with a baby chicken. Might end up having to wait another day-night cycle. Come here. Stay there. Come on. Come on. Come on, Chiggy. Come on. Come on. Right there. You do not want to cooperate, do you? Okay. Get up on there. Oh, there we go. That worked. All right, baby chickens work. All right, so I apparently misplaced one of the strings, and that interfered with the ritual. So I did get that. So now another lava legs. Upon pouring the blood on the skull, a woman appeared before you, and a voice commanded you to take her to the lava lakes of the Nether. Okay, this is weird. I don't know what I'm doing here. Whoa, hello. Hey, I didn't hit you. All right, so here's some lava lakes. Looks like this basically stopped. All right, and now what? Detection task. Upon completing the task you were given, El's mistress appeared and it seemed she wished you to prove yourself to her. Once you defeat her in combat, offer her a glass goblet and she'll fill it with her blood. If you truly wish to continue down this path, then drinking it... Oh, where'd it go? Is course action you should take. Alright, so... am I supposed to do something? Oh. Okay, I drank it. Now what? Am I not supposed to drink the chicken blood? Am I supposed to find this woman? I didn't see a woman. Did you see a woman? There's a bunch of angry zombie pigmen, but I did not see a woman. I'm confused. Oops, did not mean to do that. Location task. Upon pouring the blood on the skull. Oh, come on. I did that wrong. All right, well, I do have to wrap it up for this episode. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to do that sacrifice again with a chicken. That is pretty unfortunate, but at least I have a few chicken... Okay, these guys are going to attack me. At least I have a few chickens that I have available to do that. Apparently, I'm going to have to bring a skull down here to the Nether and probably pour it over the skull, not drink it. So that is something that I'm going to have to deal with. So hopefully that you enjoyed this episode. If you could rate and comment down below, it would be greatly appreciated. And also, if you like the series, please hit that subscribe button. But for now, get away. I'm talking. But for now, this is goodbye.